less on the lower level implementation details of code, though we'll look at a couple of examples. So this more general.
Oh, go ahead.
I was going to say more than a couple of examples. This is actually like one of the heaviest visual lectures that we have with lots of demonstrations.
Yeah, if you take a look at the syllabus at a high level, there's a lot of topics that we cover, but we spend almost an entire lecture in week three just talking about different algorithms, and we're gonna solve the same problem many different times just using a number of different algorithms.
Yeah, and I actually worry that I throw too much of the kitchen sink at this one. Like, it's fun, I think, to involve students as much as we can, and the reality is, especially now that this year's lectures are fewer but longer, they sort of naturally all fit within the same units of lecture. But I think for other teachers, especially on high schools and colleges, I'll sort of like cherry picking some of these topics is good. And I think probably I should be cherry picking as well and not using every example every year, but it's kind of hard to make the trade-off, I think.
And it's really, you know, when we have demonstrations of sorting numbers on stage or sorting people on stage, you know, eventually we're going to find out that bubble sort, insertion sort, selection sort, they're all O of N squared algorithms. They're all the same. But the way they look is really different. And I don't think you can appreciate that without seeing a physical representation of those differences.
And this one used to be very physical. So this, our touchscreen implementation, is the more modern incarnation of what used to be just a chalkboard, where I would use tape and paper and paper the board with like 8 pieces of paper behind which I would draw with chalk some numbers and have students search for those numbers.
And if memory serves, that might be one of the most memorable moments we've ever had in CS50,
yes,
actually.
Sean, bless his heart, struggled so to find the number he was searching for. But it was good. It lends themselves to these like memorable moments, right? Like, he and a lot of his classmates will never forget the time that he was trying to inefficiently search for numbers behind a door. Especially inefficiently in his case, as we'll eventually see here, but
it makes the class a lot more fun. It draws people in sometimes when things don't go well. Like, when it's kind of funny to have things go off the rails a little bit, as long as you can hopefully get it back where it's supposed to be. But yeah, I mean, this is great. It gives us an opportunity to talk about sorting and how, you know, sorted lists, you can search them eventually more efficiently, as we're gonna see now. It's good. I think it's good to have all these demonstrations and get people involved and physically seeing where these things are going.
But there's a trade-off. I mean, we know from mid and end of semester evaluations and feedback forms from students that, like, there's some students who really don't like that we get mired in some of these longer form demonstrations, right? For the student for whom binary search, linear search, and all of this comes very quickly, very naturally. They don't need to be a captive audience member in a space like this. But this is why I think it's so much more effective being able to engage with the course's content online in the video. I mean, especially now that we have tables of contents and you can very easily jump to other sections. Like, if you get this, and fun though it may be, you want to skip this, it's just all the easier. And you don't have to even manually scrub and find the next spot. You can just jump over, leapfrog this whole section entirely. And so that's what helped this year. I was much more comfortable with the kitchen sink and doing all of these demonstrations, knowing that now everything is wonderfully indexed thanks to Colton and Luke's video player, and we can very quickly jump around, or the student can, to what topics they actually do want to spend time on.
And there's something else you mentioned in that description earlier, which is these feedback forms that we actually collect at the end of every assignment. I think some people might not realize we actually do take these things really seriously. And at the end of every semester, you and I and other members of the senior staff really sit down and process all of this. And this year in particular, it became really noticeable with our switch to Python and the way we deliver lectures. But you know, we're constantly trying to improve our own delivery of content.
Yeah, this year was a big change. Certainly, I mean, the lecture times and frequencies is just the least of it. So much curricularly has changed and structurally about the class, certainly.